New research from the UIT, the Arctic University of Norway in Tromsø, has shown that enlarged left atrium is a significant risk factor for atrial fibrillation in both women and men. Why is this important? Previous studies have shown that left atrial size and mitral Doppler indices have been associated with atrial fibrillation in subgroups of elderly and subjects with prevalent disease and in studies with relatively short follow-up. We have now shown that enlarged left atrium is a risk factor for atrial fibrillation in both sexes 50 years and older in a large general population study with 16 years follow-up. Enlarged left atrium is thereby a risk factor for subsequent stroke.
Atrial fibrillation is an abnormal heart rhythm with irregular beating originating in foci in the atria. It starts as brief periods of abnormal beating, which becomes longer and often chronic over time. It can be asymptomatic, but if rapid or very slow, it becomes symptomatic. Atrial fibrillation is the most common abnormal heart rhythm, and it increases the risk of stroke and heart failure. To carry out this study, we used study participants from the 4th Tromsø study in 1994 to 95. All inhabitants 25 years and older were invited, among which 77% of the eligible population participated. In this sub-study, 2,406 participants were included. All had an echocardiography performed, and they were 50 years and older without atrial fibrillation at baseline.
The echocardiographic examinations for measuring left atrial size and mitral Doppler indices were performed using the standard parasternal long axis and apical views.
We used left atrial size and mitral Doppler indices as measured by echocardiography for evaluating diastolic dysfunction and followed up over 16 years. The outcome was the first atrial fibrillation documented on an electrocardiogram. This Kaplan-Meier plot shows years of follow-up on the x-axis and cumulative freedom from atrial fibrillation on the y-axis. The red, blue, and green line represents categories of left atrial size. We can see that the proportion without atrial fibrillation decreases with increase in left atrial size and is most prominent in the green line, which is the severely enlarged left atrium. When we adjusted for the established risk factors for atrial fibrillation, we found that women and men with severely enlarged left atria had a four-fold increased risk of developing atrial fibrillation. Adding measures of abnormal diastolic flow increased the predictive ability significantly.
Enlarged left atrium is a risk factor for atrial fibrillation and thereby for subsequent stroke. A closer clinical monitoring for new atrial fibrillation in patients with an increased stroke risk may prevent stroke. Adding echocardiography to this monitoring will identify a small subgroup with a fourfold increase in risk of atrial fibrillation.